Let's get across to Brisbane now and catch up with the LNP Senator for Queensland, James McGrath, and talk about this. Thanks for joining us, James. Christian Porter taking this action, it gives people an inquiry. A lot of people were calling for an inquiry, even though the police has said there's nothing to look at here any longer. The police can't do anything with it. But at least part of this trial, if not all of it, is going to be examining the ABC's journalism.
Totally. And people will get the inquiry that they've been clamouring for, because Christian Porter, I understand, is willing to take the stand if needed to assert his innocence in relation to the claims that have been put around about the ABC. I just want to make one comment. Christian Porter is a former Attorney General at a state level. He's the Commonwealth Attorney General. Imagine if these claims were put against someone who didn't have his legal background or the contacts that he had. Christian Porter is funding this case personally, whereas the ABC are using taxpayer money to fund their defence. And what is interesting in terms of what I understand of the statement of claim that has been filed by Christian Porter, it's going to look into to malice. The alleged
I'll come back to that, Senator, because I think that's a really, really important point. But before we get to that, one of the issues that the ABC will be using to try and defend itself is that it will say it never named Christian Porter. It put a story out there about an unnamed cabinet minister, and they will say that they didn't name him. And, of course, we can remember back to March the 3rd when Christian Porter called that press conference in Perth, and he said that he was the person named. Here's some of that.
The only thing that I can say, likely the only thing that I'm ever going to be able to say, and it's the truth, and that is that nothing in the allegations that have been printed ever happened.
OK, we'll come to that issue of malice in a moment, but this issue of identity, the statement of claim or the argument from Christian Porter says that because they identified a cabinet minister who was male and of a certain age... Now, if we just lose that graphic now, we don't want to see that now. That's not what we're talking about. They will argue that because Christian Porter because the subject of the allegations was their name wasn't published, but the fact they were a cabinet minister of a certain age and male narrowed it down to about three people. Plus, all over social media and Twitter, his name was about the place. So I suppose the argument is that the ABC, either directly or indirectly, had identified him.
The ABC, clearly, in the view of many people, did name Christian Porter through their actions, because it didn't take too long for people to do some very simple Google searches to find out that Christian Porter did attend a debating competition at Sydney University in 1988. One of my sister's friends went and asked me, is this Christian Porter? She'd spent, I think, 3 minutes doing it on Google. So it is not believable for the ABC to say that they did not identify Christian Porter. They went out of their way, it would seem, to make sure that he was the subject the subject of their story, and they did not try and disguise or hide that he was the person who was subject of these allegations. The ABC knew exactly what they were doing, and I'm so happy that Christian Porter, and so many people in Queensland are so happy that he's taken this legal action, but he shouldn't have had to take this legal action.
Yeah, well, I think another thing that looks really bad for the ABC is very clear from some of their reporting subsequently that, of course, they knew the information they had could never deliver a criminal conviction or even a civil court conviction or action against a Christian Porter. And this is where it gets to the issue of malice. And I think this is really telling, this segment of the statement of claim that we can show you now, where Christian Porter's statement of claim says Milligan, that's the ABC journalist, acted with malice, knowing of the impossibility of any finding of guilt or civil liability in the circumstances, and believing that a public campaign designed to damage his reputation would be more effective substitute against Porter in replacement of the process of the justice system. Now, this is a very, very important argument, isn't it, Senator McGrath? Because they are saying that the ABC has effectively decided that public shaming will do because the criminal justice system has left this alone.
Totally. What the ABC have done is effectively ignore the separation of powers that we have in Australia, ignored the rule of law, ignored the presumption of innocence, and decided that instead we'll have the court of public opinion as determined by the people of Ultimo, by ABC staff, as to who is guilty or innocent. The ABC, and what is pleasing about this court proceedings initiated by the Attorney General is that the journalist concerned, I suspect, is going to have to hand over everything, all the emails, text messages, all her correspondence that she's been engaged with over recent months in relation to the plaint that has been lodged by the Attorney General. And I think that will show where she was coming from and where the ABC is coming from. And you and I before have talked about the ABC, and I say I'm a fan of the ABC. Sorry, I have been a fan of the ABC because they can do a good job, especially in rural and regional Queensland, but they are becoming so out of touch of where middle Australia is, that they are now failing to understand that one of the pillars of our society is rule of law, it is the presumption of innocence, and that they have engaged on this campaign against the Attorney General. And I say to your listeners,
James
just
McGrath,
to imagine if it wasn't...
Indeed. Imagine it could easily be someone else. Thanks very much for joining us, James. That's Senator James McGrath there.